You can get a Scamp in a 13-foot, a 16-foot, or even a fifth wheel. Our first Scamp was a 13-foot Scamp, and we loved that Scamp because we could tow it behind our four-cylinder RAV4. We had the deluxe version with the wood cabinets, and we loved those cabinets because it made it look a lot less like a boat and more like a trailer. Like I said, you can pull a 13-foot Scamp behind a smaller vehicle, but be sure and check your gross vehicle weight rating and your tow rating before towing. The 13-foot Scamp is 13 feet from tongue to bumper, so it's very compact and cozy. You can get either the standard or the deluxe model, both with or without the bathroom. The deluxe model, like what we had, is the one that comes with the wood cabinets. It also has a little bit bigger bed. The bed is 54 inches instead of 44 inches. If you forego the wet bath in the standard model, you'll get a sofa that converts into bunk beds. If you forego the bathroom on the deluxe model, you have the option of having the sofa that turns into twin beds, or also you can have a small dinette that turns into a child-sized bed. That's another option. So, like I said, we had the deluxe model with the 54-inch bed, and it was tight. So I cannot imagine sleeping on a 44-inch bed with two people. With one person, I think that it would be completely fine. Now you have to remember that the bed is in the back and the back walls are curved. So the person that's sleeping on the inside of the bed is not going to have as much headroom as the person that's sleeping outside of the bed. A 1.9 cubic foot refrigerator comes standard, and it does not include a freezer, so no ice or ice cream. And that was one of the things that we missed. All models come with a two-burner stove, and as an option, you could get two of the 5-gallon propane tanks. In addition to the Scamp 13, you can also get a 16-foot Scamp. Now, the great thing about the 16-foot Scamp is that it has 5 floor plans, making it the most versatile of all the Scamp trailers. Before we sold our 13-foot Scamp, Doug and I talked about getting the fifth wheel Scamp. But the downside for him is he just thought it was too ugly. For me, I'll explain in a minute why that was a no-go. Like I said, the Scamp was great because we didn't have to get a new tow vehicle, but still there are some things on the Scamp that I would upgrade. One of the things that I would upgrade is the hot water heater, because you have to go outside and light the pilot light in order to use the water heater. Now, as an option on a Scamp, you can get electronic ignition. If I was ordering a new Scamp, I would definitely go with that electronic ignition. So another thing that a lot of people don't like, I'm okay with it obviously, is that in the Casita we have carpet. Well, in the Scamp you have something similar. People call it rat fur, which is not a very nice, it doesn't give you a warm fuzzy anyway. But it's really nice, it's comfortable, but some people just don't like that. In the Casita and also in the Scamp, the covering on the walls provides insulation, and it also provides for sound dampening. But again, if that is a no-go for you, then you'll just know that neither Scamp or Casita are right for you, because they both have that. But hold on to your hat, because I'm going to talk about some trailers that don't have this kind of wall covering. So there's another thing that I would change in the Scamp. So when Doug and I first bought our 13-foot Scamp, I was completely new to RVing. So as a reformed tent camper, I really didn't understand that there was a limit on holding tanks. I was naive, I know. And our 2008 Scamp had a 5-gallon blackwater tank. Now Scamp has a 9-gallon blackwater tank, so it's a little bit bigger, but it was a small blackwater tank. And one of the things that I didn't know or understand is that when you're in a wet bath and you're taking a shower, you need to put the toilet lid down. So needless to say, I was working in Bodega Bay and we were camping in the Scamp. And so I took my shower that morning and I didn't put the lid down. And so the black tank filled up and I left for work. And so Doug went outside and there was something dripping on the side of the trailer. And he said, oh no. You know, he figured out that it was the black water tank was full and overflowing. So he limped on over to the dump station and was able to dump without being noticed too much. And he said, fortunately, the ranger didn't come by. He was so embarrassed. And I felt really bad. So to this day, he doesn't know that that's the reason why the black water tank was full. So don't tell him. So How did the black water get all over the road, you ask? Well, the Scamp has a marine toilet, and the marine toilet has a vent on the side of the Scamp instead of, like, the Casita has a vent on the roof. So in the Casita, it'll overflow the toilet before it ever gets to the roof. But in the Scamp, it just overflowed into the vent and so went all over the ground. And so that's the reason, that's the main reason. I don't want to go through that again. And I'm sure Doug doesn't either. So that's one of the reasons why we sold our Scamp and bought a Casita. I had told the story in another video, except for I left the part out where I had left the toilet lid up and the water went in from the shower. And so somebody said that we are just like exceptional poopers. So I guess we're like super poopers. So that was one thing that I didn't like about the Scamp. The other thing was the climb over bed. It's on the back wall and it is an east-west bed instead of a north-south bed. So what we have right now in the Casita, we have two twin north-south beds. And so that was really the precipitating factor, especially for Doug, for buying the Casita, because he got tired of climbing over me in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom. So if you're young, it's probably not gonna be a big deal for you. But that was the reason why we sold the Scamp and we bought the Casita. So the Casita makes the 17-foot trailer in 5 floor plans. And they used to make a 16-foot and they used to make a 13-foot and they don't do that anymore. So if you're looking for a used trailer, you might be able to find a 16 or a 13 in the used market. But right now, if you want a brand new trailer, you can only get the 17-foot Casita. But that's okay because, like I said, they have 5 floor plans and it gives you a lot of different options. So the first option is the one like we have, which is the Independence. And like I said, the Independence, we get two twin north-south beds. We really like that because there's no climb over. But, I mean, there are some downsides to having the Independence, and that is basically the floor space. The space between the beds is very narrow. So when we're using our Casita dinette, then our, like, toes touch, we gotta kinda go off center when we're sitting down here. The plus about it that I like is we put in a lagoon table, and the lagoon table, we can just slide it out whenever we need it. So we can leave the bed set up all the time and then we just sit on the beds as a dinette. The other Casita models, you set up the dinette and then you put it down as a bed. And that's the same situation that we had in our Scamp. In our Scamp, we had either a dinette or a bed. So each of the twin beds is 30 inches, it's really 30.5 inches wide, and it's 82 inches long, so it's better for tall people. So I'm 5'8" right now, standing up tall. And you could see the ceiling height right here in the Casita. Now it's the same in the Scamp, the ceiling height's about the same in the Scamp. So that might be a consideration for you when you're looking at these trailers. So stay tuned for a trailer that has more headroom because I'm going to talk about that toward the end. So the one thing you need to know about the Casita, in every floor plan, there's standard and deluxe, but it's different than the Scamp. So in the Casita, standard means no wet bath. In the deluxe, standard means it comes with a wet bath. That's all it means. So if you, for example, get the Independence like what we have and you don't want to get the bathroom, then you can get two twin bunk beds. So that's the same in every model. You forego the bathroom and you get two twin bunk beds. So the Liberty is the most flexible, in my opinion, as far as the bed goes. Now, the Liberty, the bed is a dinette like in all other Casitas. But you can turn that dinette into two twin beds, you can turn it into a king size bed, or you can turn it into a full size bed. So it's really flexible as far as the bed goes. And our friends Cindy and Mike have the Liberty. And they are currently using it in the twin size bed configuration. So the twin beds are very narrow. But when you walk in there, you get so much floor space. It looks huge. When we were on a trip with them, we all sat down and ate together and none of our feet touched. They're really small people, so they could definitely fit with the twin size bed configuration. But if you have the twin bed configuration in the Liberty, you're gonna have a twin bed that's 24 inches wide by 80 inches long. So like the Independence, the Liberty has a 3-burner stove. Every casita has a full kitchen. You get a stove, a sink, and a refrigerator. No oven. They don't come with ovens. You can get a microwave in a casita if you want to. If you get the microwave, then you lose a lot of space for the pantry. The Casita Spirit has a dinette that turns into a double-sized bed that is 54 by 76 inches. It also has an additional dinette on the side that turns into a bed that is 72 inches long by 24 inches wide. The Liberty has a two-burner stove. If you have kids, you'll love the Heritage model, because with the Heritage model, if you forego the bathroom, you can actually have six people in your casita. I know that seems crazy, but you can. So what you get with the Heritage model is you get the dinette that turns into a bed, and then on the side, you have two twin beds, and then if you forego the bathroom in the front, then you get two more twin beds, so that's six people. Another unique layout for Casita is the Freedom. The unique thing about the Freedom is that it has an additional dinette with two comfortable chairs. So you cannot convert that into a bed. So basically, if you have the Deluxe, you're only sleeping two people. And if you have the Standard, then you can sleep four. And you have a dinette that you can leave up while you sleep in your bed, so you're not moving your dinette around. One of the manufacturers that I really like and really appreciate for the quality of their build and for the finishes in their trailer is Scamp Trailer. Now, Scamp Trailer makes a 17-foot trailer, a 19-foot trailer, a 21-foot trailer, and a fifth wheel that they call the 5.0. So they are also in the process of making an Escape 23, which is a 23-foot trailer, and it has a walk-around queen bed and two twin beds. So I'm really excited about this. It's supposed to be coming out the end of this year sometime. So I'm really going to focus on the smaller trailers for Escapes. Escape has a 17A and a 17B. The 17B has two dinettes that convert into beds and a wet bath. So I mentioned 17 because that's one of the smaller Escape trailers. I really like the Escape 5.0 fifth wheel because it has a north-south bed. It's a scooch-down bed. You have to scooch down to get out, but you're not doing the climb over, and I really like that about the 5.0. One of the things Doug doesn't like about a fifth wheel is that the fifth wheel takes up a large portion of your cargo storage in your truck bed. Snoozy Trailer touts itself as being one of the lightest fiberglass trailers that you can buy. The owner of the company told me that they have done some testing that shows that Snoozy is the most aerodynamic trailer on the market, even more than Airstream. They actually did some wind tunnel tests to show that it's the most aerodynamic. One of the things that I really like about the Snoozy 2 is that you can get it with twin beds. I love the wood in this camper. It's all red oak, no fiberglass for Snoozy. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't talk about Bigfoot Trailers. One of the reasons why I consider not even mentioning Bigfoot Trailers is because they are quite expensive. But Bigfoot makes a 25-foot fiberglass trailer, and that is a rarity in the fiberglass market. I don't know where else you're going to find a 25-foot fiberglass trailer. There's none other that I'm aware of. If you know another fiberglass trailer manufacturer that makes a 25-foot trailer, put it in the comments below because I want to know. And they are a very reputable company. They have a lot of finish options like the Escape does. They are really flexible. If you want to put a door here, you put a door here. You want to put a window here, you put a window here. So they're really flexible on your build. The building quality on the Bigfoot trailer is exceptional. One of the downsides to me, I guess it's an upside and a downside, is that Bigfoot trailers are wider. They're almost 8 feet wide. So it gives you a lot more floor space, but then it's hard to see around. You definitely have to have mirror extensions on your vehicle because it's hard to see around. If you would like to see more videos like this one, hit the subscribe button. If you'd like to see a tour of our Casita trailer, check out this video. If you'd like to see a tour of an Escape 5.0, check out this video.